On Thursday evening, after Maulana Sheikh has, they done Taraweeh and they pray Salatul Najat, Salatul Tasabih, and Salatul Shukr, he was standing for two rak'at and he passed out for 5 hours. And he said to me that in this, those who were around him, they thought Maulana Sheikh is fainted, cannot stand up back. They were trying to carry him, bringing ambulance and so on. But for what Allah reason, they delayed that to take him out of his house. He was there. And he said in these 5 hours he has been carried with Awliyaullah in the presence of Prophet ﷺ in that vision that he was seeing in his faint passing out. It's like a sleepless, but it's passed out. He was into that a whole way, that ending into a big association, he said, as if this whole universe turned into a meeting room. And he said all awliya of this century, 124,000 wali were present. And they were on one side, and he saw Anbiya'ullah on the other side. And then he saw that Mahdi alayhi salam is entering directly to the presence of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, where Prophet said, and this is Maulana Sheikh is saying, that, oh my son, ya waladi, we have dressed you dresses that has not been dressed before. It is only for that time, these dresses, because every time has its dress, every century has its own dress. We have dressed you with dress that can protect you and your follower from intiqamullah, from Allah's revenge on dunya. He said punishment is coming. There is no more any place safe on earth. Not one president or a king or a leader can stop what's going to happen. It's out of hand. Now everything in the hand of Awliyaullah, and we are addressing you that. To carry that responsibility following the footsteps of Mahdi alayhi salam. He said, Mawlana Sheikh Nazim, as soon as that said, he saw all the Khulafa al-Mahdi alayhi salam and his deputies came in one by one. They were being introduced. At that night, here, those who were here, I don't know, we did all what we have done of Taraweeh, and then we prayed Salatul Tasabih and Salatul Shukr. Then Maulana gave to my heart to recite the names of Khulafa al-Mahdi alayhi salam and their deputies, and I recited them here. That was what I have got at that night. Why, I didn't know. I said at that time that the time is being Maulana Sheikh is giving that for public information now, to hear about the names of Mahdi, because the time is now is coming out. But I didn't know about the pass out except 3 days ago by phone when I spoke with him. So he was inspiring us here to recite these names, and we read Awliyaullah and Shaykhul Islam. There are 9 sheikhs of Islam at that in the time of Mahdi alayhi salam. He said that when he passed out, they were coming in, and he was dressed with that dress, and he said, Allah gave him. They dress him with the meaning of the hadith of Prophet, لا ضرر ولا ضرار في الإسلام. لا ضرر ولا ضرار في الإسلام. There is لا ضرر, no harm, and ضرار. لا ضرر ولا ضرار, no harm and no retaliating against the harm. To do a harm against the harm. No harming and no revenge. لا ضرر ولا ضرار means if someone makes ضرر for you, harm you, you cannot go and blow someone else. What they have to do, these people? They have nothing. So no harm, and you cannot go and harm others. لا ضرر ولا ضرار. He has been dressed from that dressed, and awliyaullah, all of them with Khalifa of Mahdi alayhi salam, all of the Khalifa, 40 of them, 59 deputies, that anyone in dunya now try to make darar, harm to anyone, to any person, is not going to be accepted. They are going to get revenge from him. And he said, anyone that go and retaliate, if someone harm you and you go and retaliate against some other innocent people, they are going also to take revenge from you. That has to be stopped. And that's why he said, it's out of hand. It's in the hand of awliya now. Not in the hand of presidents, not in the hand of kings, not in the hand of leaders. It's in the hand of awliya under the order of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What he will tell them, they are going to execute, you say? Do the orders. And their orders, they don't need weapons. They don't need even a knife. They don't need even a stick. They send signals to the heart. They can reach anyone through their hearts. And he said that from that tajalli, and he called it a name, that tajalli, he said, I am addressing all my followers with tajalli al-hifz, the protection. They will be protected. And he said, every other, anyone who is speaking today, if he is on haq and he is doing haq, he is going to follow the Naqshbandi way. Anyone other than that, there will be no other tariqat except Naqshbandi. And Sayyidina al-Mahdi is a Naqshbandi, he said. Because it is the way of Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. It's called to sahibihi, لا تحزن إن الله معنا. He said to his friend, sahib, companion, don't be sad. Allah is with us. And the companion today to Prophet is Sayyidina al-Mahdi alayhi salam. And the companion to Sayyidina al-Mahdi is his ministers, and between them awliyaullah, which is Mawlana Sheikh Nazim, may Allah bless him. They are executing these orders, so protection is being dressed. And he said, is not Naqshbandi, because the name is Naqshbandi, leave the name Naqshbandi, because he is from the type of Siddiqiyun. Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq is the friend of Prophet. He is the Sadiq. He got the level of Siddiq. No one else got that level. And Mahdi alayhi salam is inheriting these secrets from Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. He was the first Khalifa of Prophet, and in this last century, the Khalifa of Prophet on earth now is Mahdi alayhi salam. And that's why he is called as As-Siddiq al-Azghar. Siddiq al-Akbar, Siddiq al-Azghar. Although he is grandchildren of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but he is means the junior who came after Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, the junior one. He's not junior or Asghar in the meaning of Asghar, but in the symbolic meaning. Means he is the one that coming in this time. And he said now, is being given the authority this year, 27 of Laylatul Qadr, that authority has been given to Sayyidina al-Mahdi alayhi salam to raise the voice for Takbir, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. And as he was saying this, he was seeing this, and he said, Maulana Sheikh, this whole universe opened, and it was like shining, Laylatul Qadr was shining. And he was making munajat that no one can understand that munajat except Awliyaullah, Mahdi alayhi salam, and Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he said, this is good tidings for all those who are following me, and this is the time of trading. And he said the best trading today is sadaqah, is to give fi sabilillah. Whatever from your wealth you give, it is not going to be 10 times more or 700 times more, as it's mentioned, 700 will be raised your rewards. It is with no limits. Anyone giving in the way of Allah is no limit. He said the most productive and the most acceptable sadaqah is what people can spread the teaching of the Naqshbandi Tariqat. If anyone can spread that teaching through any kind of media, books or tapes or TV or radio or whatever, he will be written from the Siddiqeen, from مَعَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمَ اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ النَّبِيِّينَ وَالصِّدِّيقِينَ وَالشُّهَدَاء. He will be وَالصَّالِحِينَ. He will be from that type of people that they will be together in Judgment Day. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us, and may Allah support us.